Good afternoon, everyone. Today we start our presentation with Green Cuisine Cluster. If you see on the screen, we have a special lifestyle cluster, Green Cuisine, and the head of a cluster is Marina Zabugina. She is a marketing designer at BEC already for 3 years. And actually, she has your personally passion for fantastic design, but in the kitchen. And today, we ask Marina to prepare some presentation to the topic of kale. And we have this year a special kale award. We are trying to collect some ideas, poetry, recipes, all possible ideas to the topic kale. And today is Marina's turn, and she would share with us her experience and her information about kale. Marina, please, you can start.
Thank you. Hello, everyone. My name is Marina, and today I am very glad to have the opportunity to share with you everything I know and love about kale. This wonderful plant is thriving even in frost, and it's really easy to grow it in almost every climate zone. It is one of the healthiest and most nutritious plant food in existence. It was used in Roman and Greek times. Just imagine that it has been cultivated for over 2,000 years, and it was popular in Europe till Middle Ages. But my favorite black Tuscan kale originates from Tuscany, and it was first believed to be grown in 6th century before Christ. So now you can see on the slides some artifacts, some vases or statues of the same era as this first cavolo nero. You can grow kale during any season and in most climates, as I said already before. You can grow it even in pot at home. Timing of planting will vary a little because kale does not tolerate very hot weather once it is growing. But it tolerates snow very well, so it can germinate between 5 and 35 degrees Celsius. Keep in mind that kale enjoys companion plants such as beets, celery, herbs, onions, and potatoes. But it does not enjoy being planted near strawberries, beans, and tomatoes. And if you want young leaves for salad, just sow a new batch of seeds every 4 weeks. So, kale is one of the traditional outdoor crops in Iceland, and it is growing all over the Scandinavia as well. Even Inuits of Canada are growing kale on their territories. And lucky they are, because frost changes the flavor of kale and it makes leaves sweeter and richer. In Kenya, kale is grown in small garden patches on almost all the rural farms. In many families, kale is often the main vegetable they consume. It is known as sukuma wiki, which in Swahili means to push the wick. In the last years, this plant became really popular in Kenya, and there are a lot of startups and young farmers start growing this because everybody loves kale in Kenya, in Iceland, in Switzerland, everywhere. There are different kinds of kale: Tuscan black cabbage, curly kale, scarlet kale, dwarf blue curled kale, and many, many more. I would like to advise you to sow organic heirloom seeds in your garden. Those are heritage seeds that are passed down from generation to generation. Kale is usually grown annually from seed planted in spring or autumn, and it is ready for harvest 70 to 95 days from seed. You can begin to cut individual leaves off the kale when the plant is approximately 20 centimeters high, starting with outside leaves first. But if you decide to harvest the entire plant, cut the stalk 5 centimeters above the soil, and kale will sprout new leaves again in a few weeks. Once the seed pods have fattened up and started to dry out, it is time to collect seed. Kale seeds are small, dark, and round, and might be hundreds of seed from one plant. So, shortly about the process. You collect seed pods in a paper bag and let them dry out. Then you dislodge the seeds by banging the pods, and finally you can winnow the seed. Kale is low in calories, it's high in fiber, and has zero fat. It is also filled with many nutrients, vitamins, and minerals. Just imagine, it has more iron than beef and more calcium than milk. So consider to include it in your everyday diet. It is filled with powerful antioxidants and can rightly be called a superfood. Have a look at these impressive numbers. They show an average daily level of intake sufficient to meet the nutrient requirements of nearly all people. As you can see, kale is high in vitamin C, vitamin K, and vitamin A. The tastiest food is the one you grew on your own. And there are so many delicious salads, smoothies, soups, and stews that can be done with kale. On BFC Green website, you can find a free ebook with our selection of dishes with kale. But now, I would like to share with you a recipe of kale chips that I cook often and I really enjoy them. It is a very easy recipe. Everyone can do it. You can do it with kids also, they will have fun for sure. Tear kale leaves into small pieces and massage them with oil and your favorite spices. Lay them on the baking sheet and cook in over for about half an hour. You will see those kale pieces becoming crispy. You can store them in airtight container, but actually they never stay for a long time because they are eaten like in the half an hour after they are ready. I don't know anyone who doesn't like potato chips as well. Not a very healthy treat though. And here are some tips for chips lovers who are conscious about what they eat. Get some sturdy root vegetables, anything you like, beets, carrots, parsnip, celery, potato, whatever you like. And finally, take a sharp mandolin. This kitchen tool will save you a lot of time. Slice thinly the vegetables, add some oil, herbs, spices. If you like cheesy flavor, you can add nutritional yeast or cashew paste and bake them in the oven. Enjoy them as they are. They will be delicious. Or you can even go pro and make a healthy vegan dip. Thank you very much for your attention. I hope you grew interested in this amazing plant as much as I am. And if you have any question, let me answer on them now, or please feel free to contact me anytime via Skype or email. Thank you again.
Thank you very much, Marina. It's a great presentation, great preparation, really a lot of information. Thank you very much. Please, if somebody has any questions to Marina or ideas or comments, if somebody has experience in growing kale.
Or at least in eating kale.
It's Eugene speaking. Hi, Marina. Thanks very much for the presentation. I have a question if you had experience in growing kale. this is just based on research.
Growing, but in collecting, because we have some city like urban gardens open for visitors who can come and collect it. So I have seen how it's growing, but not yet grew it by myself. But yes. Marina Kortenbusch is growing.
Yes, yes, yes. We had experience for 3-4 years. Yes, I'm so amazing with exactly these seeds, what you all have received and our clients. It's really amazing plants, and especially it's, how to say, very seldom seeds. And they're really, it's still now, it's winter, we have snow, and as Marina showed the pictures, it's nothing happened, even it's, you can still take 1-2 leaf and use it on fresh salads. And this is exactly what Marina said, it's exactly these pictures we have. It's I do not know any other, though vegetable, maybe potato also, or some, the leaf vegetables that could be so, how to say, suited for our, for strong winters conditions, so popular and extremely tasty. And just we thought about something, some really to help for biodiversity in this world, just to taste like different kales, because everyone loves, I believe we have a lot of recipes with white kale, or this is cabbage. Yes, and this is like alternative for example, in some countries, it's not known, but it's extremely interesting, and also for design, for table design, for the guest. It's always surprised, and you can mix it with nuts, and it's always my favorite chips recipes, what I am trying to bring to the guest, so self-made. So, okay. Any questions? Yes, Evgeny, you have also received seeds. Yes, right.
Yes,
would you?
Yes.
You have also a garden. What would you
of
do?
Of course, I'm interested as a potential grower. So just I'm wondering. I saw the dates, the months of planting and harvesting on the pack of seeds. But mm-hmm. anyway, I wanted to ask from practical side if. Like you, Marina, if you were growing it, have you been planting it as suggested, or maybe
no, it's completely like I have not paid any attention to the instruction, as you know. Yes, and actually we did it, and my mom did with the seeds, and then it came like zedlings or with these young plants, and then it's really, and still in the package is written like until September, and so, but still in our garden we have it, and I believe I can, it's just, you can do it during the year, and I believe it's important to experiment, yes, and even in Moldova, it's better climate, I would say, it will be like all year plants, yes, it depends maybe on the climate, but I believe it's interesting to experiment, and maybe to correct this instruction, make for example, for some regions, yes. And advice, yes. And especially, I think it's extremely interesting. Usually adults, they have no time, but extremely interesting. Some kids can just try to grow it because they have more time, like it's some projects. And even in one package, it's about 200 seeds. And so it's possible like to test like those 10 seeds and then like to make so many experiments, yes.
Okay.
Marina, does it require a lot of watering?
No, I do nothing, Evelina.
Okay.
It's really, it's like in the forest, yes? You have wild plants, yes?
I'll tell you why you do nothing, Marina, because in Switzerland you have rain every week. So that's not the case for us. I mean, we, especially my garden, it's the sunny side the whole summer.
Yes.
So that's like, it's, the soil is almost
yes.
like dry. You cannot like put a finger, your
yes.
finger in it. So it,
yes,
I
yes.
think it will depend on the region.
Maybe. Also, I was very surprised from Marina's presentation about Africa. Yes, Marina, you find the research because I never thought that it's so popular in Africa. Yes, but maybe some irrigation systems, or I don't know. But from my opinion, just it's really like so easier growing, And that's why we also choose this plant for this year, the Kale Award, just to experiment in different countries, also to promote biodiversity, but at the same time, delicious and so on. And that's why we thought with this plant, we will have less risk, yes? Just it's our objective, yes? We have also like experience with it, yes?
Mm-hmm. And it's in terms of the award, you mentioned the Kale Award. Who's gonna be? How the winner is gonna be determined? Like who grows the tallest one or the widest one?
No, I do not know. This is like first time that we decided to do some awards at BC. It's like let's see. First, we're trying to get some proposals, or like Marine is doing now presentation or recipes, or it could be some photos, just some stories maybe, or some project, just to collect it, and by the end of the year, let us just make a voting, because it's completely new, it should be like, we have again like experiment, yes? And I hope it will be some topic that we can also communicate inside of BC, and also with our clients, with everyone, with several like platforms, because what I see so many neighbors, We never talked to each other, but we started to talk to each other because of kale, because we were like so excited about this kale. Say, oh, can I pick up? Yes, and just this is something like icebreaker for communication and something topics which is really healthy, neutral, and has potential of creativity. Just this is experiment. Maybe it will be nothing. It will be like all fault. It was like I do not know, but I'm very optimistic and. Just invited them. We are also so happy to have so many participants today. It's really thank you very much for your time. And maybe if you get some ideas crazy or something, everything is welcome. It could be pictures, it could be music, poetry, it could be what you want, yes? Just the queen is Kale, yes?
I would like to say thank you for this great presentation, for in information that was shared today, and I have also a question. In terms of seeds, like we received these seeds and we can plant this first year, right? I'm just curious, like for instance, because I understand this is one year, I mean a yearly plant, and if we decide to grow it next year, is there, should we buy again seeds, or can we somehow get seed from this kale?
This is a good question, Karin. Usually, so me personally, I bought also seeds, but in my garden, just I have a feeling that they are growing further, but it's really says about 1 year plants, yes, until you have not counted. But I believe we need maybe to buy seeds, or if we will get flowers, but it was not case in my garden, because we completely like cut it down before we have not leave no one plant for flowers. Yes.
Yeah. That's what I thought.
Yes, for us it was the idea just to eat it, and we thought always you can always buy it because it's about like 2 francs. Yes, with 200 seeds you can buy it 2 francs. But even I believe for professional gardens and so you can always leave one plant and get the seeds. Yes, as Marina also presented, the seed saving process. I believe it could be work without any problem.
Mm-hmm. Okay, because for us, like next year, for those one that have gardens, they probably would be interested to preserve it.
Yes, and because, it would be really great, because I believe mutation by plants is coming. Even in these countries, maybe it will be more stronger seeds and local, yes, something, it's really very good. And maybe if next year, if somebody in our partners' countries and so would say, oh, this is local seeds, yes, and we will have own seeds without buying from Switzerland. This could be interesting, yes.
And another thing, for those that are not gardening in or don't have the gardens, I'm just curious, like, if it's, how it is adapted to apartments or growing on balcony gardening, I mean, how it is called. Maybe Marina can also share it.
because I know, for instance, from Arturo, also
he shared with us last year that he's growing some plants in Holland, Netherlands, like parsley and other stuff on the balcony.
Is it adaptable to be grown on the balconies of apartments?
Yeah, you can grow it. Just get a big pot. It should be at least 38 square centimeters of space, so the kale can have enough space for roots and enjoy itself in this ground. And yeah, it will grow.
Mm-hmm. All right. And it is a sun lover or it's shade? Shade.
Shade lover.
Shade. Okay. All right. Thank
but
you.
Also at all we have a very open place. Yes, it's like no shadow. It's
yeah, but
just
in Slovak, sometimes the sun can be.
It's too hot. Okay. Yes, because we had also different summers. Every year, like last 3 years, sometimes it was too many rains or no rains at all. But it's I had every year amazing results with this kale.
I'm going to plant some at my home and take maybe daily photos. Then maybe with Eugene, we may make a nice like clip of daily progress how it's growing. Yes. Second, I guess everyone knows already, I tried to plant about 2 hectares of potato to see how it goes in a potato region in mountains. And there will be, as I understand now, there will be maybe 200, 300 excessive square meters on which we won't plant the potato. It's a bit more than 2 hectares and we have everything for 2 hectares. So I will see how this place could be used for the kale.
Wow, fantastic. Because I would say it's huge, fantastic. Potatoes and kale, yes? What could be better, yes? As dishes, yes?
No, sort of. So,
it's interesting.
Yes, so the temperature there in the summer will not go more than 27 degrees, so it's not very hot there. As potato doesn't like the hot regions, it stops growing when it's hot. So we'll make experiments. This I'll use a couple of seeds for home, and I will plant one in the office also, and then we'll see how it goes in 1 year.
It's fantastic, George, because also to Tajikistan, not Albania, in Serbia, we send potatoes. Like special potatoes, which are special, could be like old sorts that could grow at like 2,000 meters in the mountains. And also Kyrgyzstan before it, yes? And we have some people, if you say you already growing potatoes, I did not know about it, yes? And just like next package, we'll go to Georgia with potatoes, and maybe we can really experiment like different arts of potatoes. It's a real like amazing taste. You can smell potatoes with like lemon or mushrooms. It's really about like biodiversity, interesting art. No, you see, like I'm so happy that we have some platform in Georgia. So for tasting, for experimenting.
Well, yes. So if I guess this unused part of potentially unused part of land will be a bit more than this one package of kale seeds can handle. So feel free to, if you want to something else to experiment, because the land will receive everything. It is fertilized now, but for potatoes, but anyway, it's cultivated. It's now these fertilizers are slowly reacting with the soil. So by the spring, it will be a perfect land for them. And it will receive the watering regularly.
Yes, yes, fantastic, because also what we are calling about kale award this year, but always we do not want to have kale as a monoculture. And we sent in the pictures with flowers, what you can eat, or potatoes. This is, if somebody really focus on some others, it's also okay. Marin, maybe you can show and this BCR award, this scale, you can order, you can contact us and to order the seeds from the special formulary, yes, that we have created. At the moment, it's only for kale, but also it's possible send a message, write some message or specification, and we will try, like, as time permits, something we are not so quickly, but we are trying, like, really to promote it, yes, and send the packages. I would very quickly maybe using the opportunity to present the clusters which we still have and the progress of our initiatives. Just at the moment we have Green Cuisine. Today it was presentation from Marina, she's the head of it. We have Little Enterprises, we decided like to call it yesterday, and I will take the leadership and especially focus on activities with kids and parents who is like open to some experiments and so on. And it could be like mathematics for kids, it could be like shock value chain or all as possible activities, yes, and postcards and so. Speechcraft, it's Colleen was volunteered and he's happy to organize organize like symbiose from Toastmasters and with under BFC. Just that at this platform we can also join the online club and get our certification without like visiting some clubs. It already exists. And at the same time, train our rhetoric skills. And for example, today what Marina's presentation it could be easier rate with Toastmasters, provide feedbacks and then like start to count for certification. Yes. And this is Passion for Sound. It's really extremely interesting, powerful, developed by Andrei. And we got already some people in Switzerland who is connected and want to support it. And especially like a man who is 82 years old and he knows personal Beatles, played with them like professional musicians. And also Rolling Stones, just a legend of the people. And we hope we will be really happy, Andre and Jim, and also like society at the moment, we are singing leads in Russian. Jim wants to learn Russian, and we want to have passion for sound. And I'm very happy for this development. It's still open creative farming, health and motion reading room. It's no leadership. And today, some of the people from BC, Dmitry Bobrev and some consultants say, oh, we are learning languages, and maybe we will open a new cluster like learning languages. Maybe Alena, I don't know, Tamara, who is working with Alison, but Dmitry is learning German, and Colleen learning French, and maybe we can also do some clubs like with special topics. And everybody is invited to take leadership, like to just create own cluster. Also, the design of website is still not optimized. We still thinking, like this is the testing, we try trying to test it, what's work, what does not work, optimize it. But even every ideas, for example, recipes from Nata or the Alena or the any ideas, we really ask to post from on Facebook, trade ideas on iShare for sharing with us, and after that we can try to systemize it to see what's about clusters. And what I also see, it's in Switzerland, they're very active with hubs in Switzerland. It's going like we really got very good connected with musicians, this is Russian songs, musicians, and artists with painters, postcard painters. Really, we got fantastic people from Switzerland who is very interested, also journalists. And just 1 hour ago, I have received from Georgian Friends of Switzerland. It's like a non-profit association, and Moldavian Friends of Switzerland. Yes, I received like invitation to join these clubs. And again, this is, I hope, will be some impulse for to came through our dream about our hubs in Moldova, Georgia. And we are trying like to be in network with some like microfinance initiative in Switzerland, like to get people also to invite to our hubs and our website, like external people, not only BC, and also use this Facebook I share with different hobbies, ideas, patients, and maybe also we're thinking about maybe we will recall this, also any ideas are welcome, maybe we will call like online community or something we're thinking like, anyway, we are like in some process and see who will be active, what time will be better, what format is working. And today in the morning, it was really a lot of participants from BC and a lot of questions about how to grow kale. And I see we will have a nice pictures from Georgia and also from Moldova and Kyrgyzstan and Ukraine, definitely, yes. And Switzerland, 100%, yes, we're just experimentizing. And I hope also if some adults will say, oh, seeds, it does not work, and so I'm really going to do it with kids, and Michael is motivated to make some presentation in February in Moldova and Swiss, in Georgia, like Shoki workshop with kids, and just to make something like memorable, but at the same time, maybe some to organize some tops, not also to put the seeds of kale and see how they're growing, and kids can do it, and maybe make a painting. It could be, still, I think about any ideas are welcome. And let's see, I hope we will be lucky with many initiatives and from different countries, and let's see how it works, yes, how it will be, yes, during this year. I'm very optimistic and looking forward for your feedback, your ideas, and together work, yes, and even not only in frame of BC, just everywhere, yes, to be connected. So thank you very much. This is all from my side. If you have any questions to this presentation or this platform, if not now, just feel free to contact me individually anytime this next week. We are extremely, extremely interested in your feedback, your ideas, and thank you very much for your time, for being with us.